Hello, I'm Pete Bocini. Today I'll be giving an overview of my project that I've been working on at NASA Glenn Research Center, the design of novel cobalt-based superalloys. So what is a superalloy? Well, superalloys are alloys which maintain their mechanical strength and stability at temperatures that most other alloys fail at. Superalloys are comprised of a two-phase microstructure consisting of L12 type precipitates, which I'll call gamma prime, that are embedded in a disordered FCC matrix, which is known as gamma. The high volume of precipitate serves to block plastic flow in these metals and are very stable up to high temperatures. Most superalloys are nickel-based. However, cobalt, which has a 40 degrees C higher melting temperature than nickel, has recently been shown to form the same type of microstructure. NASA Glenn owns a scanning electron microscope specifically designed to image magnetic materials, such as cobalt. Here I'm loading a sample into the chamber to investigate the microstructure of my alloy. The computer display shows the two-phase gamma plus gamma prime structure in backscatter mode. In the creep lab, I prepare my cylindrical compression sample for testing by sandwiching the alloy between two lubricated silicon carbide platens. This ensures that equal stress is distributed along the entire sample. The creep frame primarily consists of two compression rods surrounded by a furnace. I meticulously position my sandwich sample so that it is placed in the center of the rams. Thermocouples are then tied around the sample so that the temperature can be measured during testing. Once this setup is complete, weights are placed on the end of a lever arm, which then presses against the top compression ram. A displacement sensor measures how much the sample is deformed, and through this we can see how resistant to plastic flow these new alloys are. Thanks for listening. I'm Pete Bocini, a proud Blue Hen alumni and current PhD candidate at Northwestern University.